What's up, guys? Human Carjack here, and today we have my cousin Alex here.
What up, fellas? What's going on?
So first things first, what we're gonna do is we're gonna start off with some intake valve and turbo cleaner. You guys might have seen my previous videos where we do the air oil separator install. I've been getting some funky numbers on the access port recently, so we're gonna try and clean the inside of the intake valves. Hopefully that'll at least temporarily fix the problem. Eventually in the near future, we're gonna do a walnut blasting to kind of clear out all the gunk that's in there, but for now, we're gonna stick with this. So that's step one for today. Alex is gonna go ahead and head into the car. He's gonna keep the engine at 2000 RPM, and as soon as we're done emptying out this bottle, we have some brakes to install. All right, ready?
Yeah.
Got it. All right, so we just finished the process with the CRC intake cleaner, and it actually bogged a lot more than usual, so there might have been a really big buildup. So I'm gonna wait until this stops smoking. We're gonna go ahead and replace the sensor back onto the hole. And for now, we're gonna get to the brakes. All right, so we've got the car all jacked up. Went ahead and took off all the lug nuts. We can go ahead and lift it up a little bit higher. And I'm gonna go ahead and start to take off the brake rotor. First things first, went ahead and took out these 14 millimeter bolts. I used the ratchet right over here. Okay, so one is on this side of the caliper and one is on the bottom. All right, so now it should be free to come off. All right, so I managed to actually just take it off by hand. So it was just those two 14 millimeters. So what we're gonna do now is set that off to the side. You're gonna take off the other piece and then we can go ahead and remove the whole brake rotor. All right, so we got the whole brake caliper off, and now it's time for the rotor. So pretty interesting, the way that you take the rotor off, there's a bolt right over here that we found on the inner part of the, I guess, what part did we find it on?
The brake hose line.
Yeah, the brake hose line, and it was a 12 millimeter?
Yeah.
So it's a 12 millimeter, and what you do is you stick it in here, you start to torque it down, and then it actually pushes the rotor off of the pan over there that's holding it in place. Nice, all right, cool. Out with the old, in with the new. Now you guys haven't seen these yet, but these are our new brake rotors by Duralast. And Duralast, if you're watching this, please feel free to sponsor me, or sponsor us. So here we go, we got the Duralast GT brake rotors. This is a street rotor. It's slotted, so it's a little bit more high performance, so hopefully we get a little bit better bite and stopping power out of this. Now for science purposes, we're gonna go ahead and weigh out the rotors. So first I'm gonna go ahead and weigh myself. I'm gonna step on the scale here. And how much are we weighing now? Yeah, 500 pounds. Look at that, I'm jacked. 160.1. All right, so 160.1. All right, let me go ahead and hold on to the stop rotor first. See how much we weigh now. Let me zoom this in first a little bit. There we go. All right, so let's see what we got. So before we had 160.1, now we have 181.6. So it's about 21 pounds on the stock one. And on the GT, GT actually feels heavier. What do we say the other one was? 181.6? Oh. Yeah, just about a pound and a half more, so it's not too bad. So I went ahead and used a wire brush on the inside of this piece on the caliper. Went ahead and kind of sanded it up, took off all the rusted pieces and all like the dirt and stuff that was left over on the brakes. And then we kind of got a chance to rough up this part. I don't have the proper sized wire brush. Like this thing is pretty big, so it doesn't really fit in here that well. But I did what I could, sprayed it with some brake cleaner. So now I want to show you guys a quick comparison of the new pads compared to the old ones. So top ones are our new pads, the bottom ones are the used ones, and they are by Hawk Performance. So they're street legal pads, high performance street. Same thing with the brake rotors. They're a street edition rotor, but they're meant for like more high performance. So we'll see how these work together. So rotor is on, we managed to slip one piece of the caliper on as well as the brake pads. One thing you have to note, a lot of these new brake pads, they come with grease, so make sure that you put that on. We applied it to the tips right over here. Get it to focus, yeah, right over there, that red stuff that's sticking out right there and right there on both sides, just to make sure that we don't squeak as much. You're probably gonna get some squeaking anyway, but just not as bad. So the last thing that has to go on now is the other piece of the caliper. We're gonna go ahead and screw that all on, do the other side, and we should be done. And that's it, that's all she wrote. So it's looking pretty good. Torque down the bolts to, I mean, honestly, not that tight. I don't know the torque specs. You can go ahead and probably find that in the user manual or somewhere on Subaru's website, somewhere there. But honestly, it's looking pretty good right now. It's feeling pretty solid. I'm gonna go ahead and do the same job to the other side. I'm gonna go for a test drive. Don't worry, this is all just from the CRC. It's still spitting out all that carbon. All right, so what we're doing now is we're gonna go in for a little ride. We're gonna try and prep the brakes a little bit. So as soon as I started up the car, I had to prime it a little bit, so stepped on the brakes a little bit, get the fluids kind of passing through the calipers and everything. And now what we're gonna do is, like, right now I'm just driving regularly, like not really stomping on the brakes or anything. We're gonna find a straightaway around this corner and we're gonna give it a couple of really good brake checks, just to really test it out and see what the bite is like, see if there's any squeaking too. We did put grease, hopefully that holds up. But let's see how good it's feeling now. I don't think we're gonna get a real good feel of performance as of yet, because we're not really like on the highway or anything, but we can just test it out for now. All right, so brake check number one. It's a pretty good bite. That wasn't too hard of a press, but we're gonna start going gradually more and more. You give it a little bit of gas. Brake from 40. It's a pretty good bite. It feels pretty good. Alright, so enough of that. So that was pretty good. So we did a couple of pretty hard stops from 40 miles per hour. The brake feel feels great. I'm gonna be able to tell a little bit more as time goes on. But for now, this is good. Eventually in the future, I'm gonna go ahead and swap out to stainless steel braided lines, along with some Motul brake fluid, the 600 edition. It's a little bit more racy, but it's still fit for the street. And that's pretty much the idea behind these rotors and pads as well. They're both street performance, but they work pretty well on the track too. So the footage you guys just saw was from 2 weeks ago, and we didn't manage to do the rear brake rotors. I actually put in the pads earlier this week, but I didn't do the rotors. So these rotors actually aren't too bad, but I figured because we got new ones in the front and I got new pads over here, might as well get some new rotors as well. Now, unfortunately, I couldn't find any slotted rotors like the front ones for the rear, but I did get some Pro Stop ones that do fit the Forester. Now, these are definitely a little bit more basic than the front setup, but as long as they fit, they should do a good job. They're brand new, so why not? They should perform a little bit better. And just like the first half of the video, we're gonna go ahead and weigh these, compare them to the stock rear rotors, and see if we do get some weight reduction. Hopefully we do, since the front ones were 2 pounds heavier. I really hope that these are a little bit lighter, just to not really get the car a little bit, you know, heavier. So the lighter, the better. So we're gonna go ahead and begin removing it. It's pretty much the same process as the front. So I'm gonna give you guys a little bit of a time lapse. All right, so we moved the caliper. These are our new Hawk brake pads that we installed recently. So we can go ahead and leave this just as is. Another reason why I'm really happy about replacing these is all the overspray that I got on it from painting the calipers. So this is gonna look nice and clean now. And don't forget to remove the bolt that we took out just like before in order to remove the rotor. Now, before we get to the rest of this, I went ahead and bought some brake cleaner from Pep Boys. Not only did we get brake cleaner, but we also got engine degreaser. So I'm hoping that for the calipers, because they're super dirty right now, I'm hoping that maybe this will be a little bit more heavy duty. I mean, it says it's heavy duty and it's for the engine, but hopefully it could help remove some of the grime that's on the calipers. So what I'm thinking of doing is I'm gonna put this on first. It says you're supposed to rinse it off. So I'm gonna put this on first, then I'm gonna go ahead and slightly rinse it, and then I'm gonna go ahead and put the brake clean on. So we got our calipers sitting right over here. I'm gonna go ahead and take the pads out, remove them, get them out of the way. I don't want them getting any of this stuff on it, because I don't know if it's good for the pad itself. Probably isn't, so better safe than sorry. All right, so our pads are up. We're gonna go ahead and place them to the side, out of the way, so we don't get any of the engine degreaser on it. We're gonna let that soak for like 5 minutes, and we're gonna go ahead and grab the hose, put it on a higher pressure setting, and then we're gonna rinse it all off, go right into the brake clean. So I'm gonna go ahead and let this piece dry for now. We're gonna spray with brake clean once it's dry, and we're gonna make our way over to the car once again. You know what, since we're here, I'm gonna go ahead and mask off these little rubber pieces over here. We got some tape here, and I've got some leftover caliper paint when I first painted the calipers, and I never actually took them off to do it. I don't know why I didn't. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and keep letting it dry. I'm gonna spray it with brake clean, and I'm gonna brush some of this dirt off, spray it with brake clean again, try and get it as clean as possible. I mean, like, yeah, it's not gonna get that much cleaner, but you know, it is what it is. It's gonna be a rough job, but as long as it looks nice and it covers up the whole surface of the caliper, I'm pretty okay with it. Just spray the brake cleaner on after putting the engine degreaser. I'm gonna go ahead and give it a little bit more. So we're gonna let this dry one more time, and I got a piece of wire. We're gonna go ahead and hang up the caliper just so that it's kind of suspended in the air. I'm gonna go ahead and spray all around. Again, like we said, we're gonna mask off these little rubber parts. Got the dope setup over here hanging from the tree. So no prep really, other than the brake clean, so no sanding, no none of that. I don't really wanna take off the existing red paint, just gonna paint over it. Honestly, I didn't even prep the surface when I did it the first time around, and it's been holding up pretty good. I mean, you guys could see it right there. So yeah, I don't really care about it looking super, super nice. But as long as we have those rubber pieces all covered up, it should be pretty good. So I'm gonna go ahead and start spraying. So coat number one is all finished. I'm gonna go ahead and let this dry up a little bit. Very light layer. We still have a bunch of pieces over here on the inside that are still not painted. I'm gonna leave this here for now. I'm not gonna show you guys all the layers that I'm gonna be doing, but I'm gonna leave it here. We're gonna go ahead and go back to the car and go ahead and throw on the new rotors. So we went ahead and transferred this little rubber plug that came on the stock rotors onto the new ones. So let's go ahead and fit them on into position. Right over there. Looking nice and clean. So as for this part of the caliper, I think it's gonna be more of a pain in the ass to do this, and I'd have to disconnect it from the line over here. So I'm gonna go ahead and leave it like this. I'm gonna put some brake clean on it, clean it up a little bit, but I'm not gonna paint it, and the side that isn't painted doesn't even show, so I really don't care about this too much. So we're gonna go ahead and clean this up a little bit. Gonna go ahead and finish up spraying our other caliper, which is right over there. And we're gonna finish this job up, do the same thing on the other side. Oh yeah, and I almost forgot to weigh both of these. So holding the stock rotor in hand, we go ahead and step on. Let's see what we get here. We're at 170.3. And I know last time I weighed myself first and then this, but this actually feels a lot lighter. So 170.3, let's see how much it is now. All right, it's about 2 pounds lighter. So that's pretty cool. So the front ones that we got, the Duralast GTs, those were 2 pounds heavier than the stock ones. And now these Duralast ones are actually 2 pounds lighter. than the stock one. So that really, really works out. So it balances everything out. So I'm really happy about that. The only downside is that they're not slotted, so they're not going to repel heat as much as I'd like them to. But I couldn't find any local stores that had the slotted ones for the Forester that were at a reasonable price. There were some options available online, but honestly, I'd rather just go to a store and get it immediately and not have to wait for it to come in like a week. I usually have very limited time during the week, so this worked out perfectly. All right, everything is completed. The rotors are looking really good. The calipers are looking nice and cleaned up with a fresh coat of paint. The one thing I want you guys to keep in mind is that I don't know if you saw that little rubber tab that was on the stock rotor. So it was in this position right over here. We had transferred it over to the new rotors. So basically what that is, it's put in place for your parking brake. So let's say you go ahead and you finish your rotor job, installing your rotors and everything, and you go to pull up on your parking brake and it's not really making contact that well, and like the car starts to roll forward or it's just not really functioning properly. The idea behind that is you take off that little rubber piece and then it has a little part to it where you stick a tool, screwdriver or something like that. Basically what you do is you have to adjust it just so that it's making contact with the rotor. So as you turn it, it expands and then it makes contact with the rotor just so you can have a better parking brake feel. So we're all done for now. I'm gonna go ahead and eat some food now, and a little bit later I'm gonna go for the final test drive. We'll be right back.